In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use multiple glare nodes to create a strong glow effect. Let's add a UV sphere. Control 1 to subdivide. Right-click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. I'll add an emission shader. If we render this scene, we won't see any glow effect. That's because we haven't added a glare node yet. Let me add a viewer node, so we can see the result. That's how the glare effect works, but sometimes we would need a stronger glow effect than that. When using a single node, there is an absolute limitation on how bright the glow can be. If we add more glare nodes, the glow becomes far more stronger. This is one of the best ways to create a strong glow effect in Blender. The settings can be customized like this. Here is an example scene I've made. I'll show you how the meshes and the materials were created in detail. For the background checker pattern mesh, I have created a plane, tab, to go to edit mode, and right-click to subdivide. I have subdivided the plane 15 times. After that, I typed 3 to face select, and checker deselected the selection. I have assigned two separate materials like this. I'll show you how the material nodes look like. This is the base material. This is the gradient material for the checker selected faces. I have used a UV sphere with an emission shader as the mesh in the middle. Then I created a torus and scaled it. After that, I pressed Shift, D, to duplicate, and, R, to rotate. Control, 1, to subdivide. Right-click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. Here are the material nodes. I have arranged the render angle this way, and rotated the background plane to make it look better. This is the final composite node. I'll show you how the scene looks like without the glade nodes. This is when three glare nodes are applied to the image. I'll reduce the number of glade nodes to show you the difference. This is when only one glade node is used. This is when two glare nodes are used. This is the final result. Here are the full nodes. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.